Hi, my name is Pranay Mehel, and in this video, I am taking you along on my bird safari in Gujarat, India. I am going to visit two places to photograph migratory birds. One of them is Null Sarovar, and the other one is Little Rann of Kutch, also known as LRK. I and my naturalist Deep took a flight from Nagpur and landed straight at Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel International Airport, Gujarat. My bird safari guide Ramzan has come to pick us up. From the airport, we are now headed straight towards the Null Sarovar. I guess this is where our adventure is beginning. We hear a commotion of hundreds of birds. These are demoiselle cranes, but they are still a bit far away. So Ramzan is taking me closer to them. He's teaching me how to keep a low profile while approaching the birds. This way the birds don't see us as human beings and don't get frightened. And we get to click good photographs from close distance. Now we have come to this farmland to see a very rare bird known as Namakwa dove. Ramzan has spotted the bird several times in this area. By the time we got a glimpse of the bird, it was getting dark and the bird was too far away. This is day 2. It's early morning and we are on our boat ride of Null Sarovar. Null Sarovar is a marshland with shallow water spread over 120 square kilometers. The sun is out and the bird activity is slowly starting. We just have to wait for the perfect photo opportunity and it could take hours. I managed to capture this photograph of a lone heron. We are moving around exploring different parts of the lake. These are black-headed gulls and they are present here in large numbers. Further ahead, I saw a beautiful large pelican and I captured this image. Now we are entering the grasslands, which are full of birds, but spotting them requires excellent skills.
Namaste.
Namaste.
In the deeper sections of the grasslands, we spotted this swamp hen. This is a pond heron, a white-throated kingfisher, pelicans, a purple heron, a black-headed gull. After spending hours in the boat, we were hungry and decided to stop for lunch on this beautiful island in the middle of the lake. This island is only accessible by boat. There are no permanent settlements on this island, but local tribal people have small restaurants here where one can enjoy local meals. I must say, interacting with these tribal people was a nice experience. By late afternoon, we were done for the day and took this beautiful highway to go back to my hotel. After traveling for 3 hours and approximately 80 kilometers, we have now reached Zainabad. This village themed house is where I will be staying for the next 2 days. I am staying at an eco lodge named Desert Courses. They will be providing a safari vehicle along with a local driver who will also be my guide, who will take me on a safari of Little Rann of Kutch. And I'm off to my first safari of LRK. We got into a little traffic jam, but were clear in no time. This entire desert-like region is known as Little Rann of Kutch. We have first spotted the Indian wild asses, which are endemic to this region. The Indian wild ass is considered to be endangered due to habitat loss and fragmentation, hunting and competition for resources with domestic livestock. The Indian government has set up the Indian wild ass sanctuary in Gujarat to protect the species. The sanctuary covers an area of 4,953 square kilometers and is home to around 4,000 Indian wild asses. The Little Rann of Kutch is home to various kinds of bushes and shrubs that are well adapted to the arid conditions of the region. Hidden in the shrubs, we found a large spotted eagle owl. The owl is comfortably sitting in the shade of the shrubs, yet I am taking extreme precaution not to startle it. The sun has already set and we are now going to find the Egyptian nightjars. But before that, the spotted hyena ran across our vehicle. Egyptian nightjars are difficult to spot as they very successfully camouflage themselves with the ground. Our driver was so skillful that he was able to spot them in this darkness, that too while driving a vehicle. This is my last day at LRK, and it's the 9th day since I've left home for the tiger safari. For the past 9 days, I have spent my entire time visiting forests and deserts, exploring and photographing wildlife, and it has been a splendid experience. Today we got lucky and came across this rare bird. This is a peregrine falcon. It is famously known as the fastest bird in the world. Not only is it the fastest bird, but it's the fastest animal on the planet. They are capable of reaching speeds of over 320 km per hour in a dive. They primarily hunt other birds, which they catch mid-flight by striking them with their powerful talons. Their diet includes pigeons, doves, ducks, and other birds. Peregrine falcons were once listed as endangered due to the widespread use of pesticides like DDT, which caused thinning of eggshells and reduced reproductive success. However, since the ban on DDT in many countries, their population have recovered, and they are now listed as a species of least concern by the IUCN, which is the International Union for Conservation of Nature. We have moved further ahead in our search and are now spending time with spectacular flamingos. I love watching these beautiful birds. We are seeing two species of flamingos here. The vibrantly pink are the greater flamingos, whereas the not so vibrant ones are lesser flamingos. Watching flamingos having their food made us realize that we are hungry too. So we have decided to have our breakfast with flamingos in the backdrop. The water body on the screen left is full of hundreds of flamingos, and this was the most exciting part of the day. Later in the day, I shared my wildlife experiences with some new friends, and the next day, I flew back home to make preparations for my next wildlife expedition. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.